Is it arrogant to return to a place you've never been? I mean, it pretty much sums up the American girl. It sums up the premise of the book pretty well.
Hello, everyone. My name is Noor Naga, and I am the author of If an Egyptian Cannot Speak English. And you are here with me in my home, in Maizi, in Cairo, Egypt.
Cairo is the one place I don't have to explain myself in any way. People immediately understand me, and they understand me in a complex and nuanced way. When the New York Times review came out, I thought there had to be some mistake. I saw it on Twitter or something. Nobody emailed me. I sort of saw it in passing and then was convinced there was something wrong.
I would have loved to show you some of my favorite books here, but unfortunately this is a lending library and many of them are out with friends.
This is where I do most of my writing and reading and socializing and living. I have all kinds of trinkets around that remind me of people I love. Photos and notes from friends. Or recognize the skyline. This is my writing setup most of the time, and it usually starts with Zoom, which means that it usually starts around 2 or 3 p.m. because I'm trying to catch all my friends in Toronto that I write with. This means that my mornings are very slow. I do a lot of yoga, I do a lot of, you know, walking to the bakery and getting something to eat.
This is the street where I live. It's lined with sycamore trees, which are native to Egypt, actually, one of the few trees that are. They're very old. The pharaohs actually used to use the wood from these trees to make their coffins, and they're just really beautiful and gothic. It's like a Dali painting.
Michael Ondaatje is also another favorite of mine who I dream to meet, so just throwing that out there in case the killer wants to make it happen.